Use Integration Hub to build reusable integrations with third-party systems and connect them from anywhere in the Now platform. With this capability, you can create spokes, data streams, and data imports. You can access Integration Hub spokes from Workflow Studio. Select connections to view spokes that have inbound or outbound connections. Use the search bar to search for specific spokes. In this case, we'll select an outbound connection for the required spoke. Select View Details to configure the spoke's connections. The Configure Connection dialog box appears, and you can enter the connection and credential information for the spoke. Now Assist in Spoke Generator creates spokes and automates integration tasks. Let's see how it works. Select New Spoke. The Spoke Info page appears, and you can specify if you want to create the spoke in a new or existing scope. In this case, we'll create a spoke in a new scope. The Build Info page shows the different ways you can create the spoke, like using an API specification, Postman collection, or documentation. Select Now Assist, then Continue. This enables you to generate reusable actions by providing the required third-party API documentation. The Generate Action page contains the Now Assist context field. Copy and paste the API documentation to this field, then select Generate Preview. The action preview generated by Now Assist appears and displays the action properties, input variables, step configuration, and output variable. An error message will be displayed if there are any missing fields. Next, select Continue to create a new connection and credential alias. Enter the name and authentication type, then select Create Alias and Continue. Add the connection URL and the API key. If you want to configure the alias record at another time, select Do It Later. When all the information is entered, select Submit. The connection alias record is created, and we can publish the action. While the action is being created, we can add a new action or visit the spoke page. We'll select Go to Spoke page to view the published spokes. Use data stream actions to send REST or SOAP requests from Workflow Studio to APIs that return paginated responses or responses larger than 10 megabytes. Data stream actions allow flows to process large requests by processing each object in the data stream using for each flow logic. Data stream actions can also create data sources for other imports like sets and IH import. You can create a data stream action from Workflow Studio or from an existing spoke. Select Data Stream, then configure the action properties. Data stream actions have a fixed structure consisting of 5 sections: inputs, action preprocessing, request, parsing, and outputs. Use action preprocessing to retrieve connection and credential details or to run a preprocessing script. The request category configures how the action sends API requests and executes once per page of results. Parsing configures how the action separates data stream elements into complex data objects. Integration Hub Import configures, runs, and schedules data imports through a consolidated interface. In the Name and Description fields, enter the details for a new data import integration. On the Source Configuration page, you can define the data source for an import. The Source Configuration page contains the Source Type menu, File Upload or Connection section, Configuration section, and Source Data Structure preview. Select Properties to view the name of the integration, its description, and application scope. On the Map to Target page, you can add a table, transform settings, and view target table cards. Select the target table drop-down list to view the options for the target table, like properties, edit mapping, table configuration, revalidate, and delete. Select a target table name to view its data mapping. The data mapping section includes the target table name, source data section, and target table data section. Toggle the match switch to specify fields where the system should check for matching data and update existing records. When Match is activated, it will update existing records rather than create new ones. Select Mapping Properties to view or edit the options to run the table's business rules when importing and to run the import synchronously. Use AutoMap to automatically map source entities to similarly named target entities. Open the Data Pill Picker to map source data pills to field values in the target table. Select the Transform function icon to see the list of available transform functions and edit your data. On the Schedule Imports page, you can run an import immediately or schedule it to run at a certain time, interval, or after a parent import. Import schedules are listed under the Run and Schedule Import section. Select Schedule and Import to create an import schedule. The Execution section includes links to execution records, execution context records, and scheduled import records. Select Run Import to run the import once. Select an execution record to view the execution details. The Execution Details section displays cards that contain the total number of rows imported, processed, pending, or skipped, and the number of errors that occurred. It also includes the Partitions card, which features a graphical view of the import set partitions. You can also view the details for each partition in list view. The Import Details section includes import set rows, outbound HTTP requests, action execution history, import logs, and errors for each execution record. With Integration Hub, process owners and developers can combine and integrate automation capabilities in one place, making it easier to build and show business processes. To learn more, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.